Brain of Britain, the nationwide general knowledge contest, chaired by Russell Davis.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for that lovely welcome from the radio theatre audience here at Broadcasting House in London. Four more eager and hopeful competitors join me on the stage for the seventh of the 2022 Brain of Britain heats. For one or more of them, a place in the semi-finals awaits later in the autumn. And with that, I'll ask our contenders to introduce themselves.
Hello, I'm Roger Bowen from Blaenavon in South Wales, and I'm a retired housing officer.
Hello, I'm ALISON JAY. I'm a retired speech and language therapist, and I live in Suffolk.
Hi, I'm NED PENDLETON, a professional gambler on football from Northamptonshire.
I'm GAIL TRIMBLE. I'm a university lecturer from Oxford.
And you're all very welcome. I should remind you that you all get 10 seconds to think about your answer when it's your own turn, so please don't flash your lights at me to signal you'd like to come in for a bonus until the first contestant has had that thinking time. The first light to go on will disable the other, so I can always see who pressed first, but I can also see if you're jumping the gun, and I'm afraid we have to take a dim view of that, so be prudent, please. Good luck, everyone. The first question today, ruled by the order of the alphabet, goes to you, Roger Bowen. In March 2022, scientists announced they'd discovered which lost vessel, the ship of Antarctic explorer Sir Ernest Shackleton?
Erebus?
No. NED PENDLETON?
Discovery.
No. ALISON JAY?
Endeavour?
No. GAIL TRIMBLE?
Fram?
No, it was Endurance. It had been one of the greatest ever undiscovered wrecks, found in the Weddell Sea 107 years after it sank. ALISON JAY, your turn. The actor John Leeson provided the original voice of which robotic character in Doctor Who?
K-9
is right. He also played Bungle in Rainbow. Which early colonial settlement on the American continent was named after the first Stuart monarch?
Jamestown.
A suburban cul-de-sac called Pine Oak Court has been a regular sight on TV for many years. By what name is it better known?
Brookside?
No. Now then, GAIL TRIMBLE.
Coronation Street?
Nope. Any more guesses? NED PENDLETON?
Hollyoaks?
Nope. No more tries. No, it's Ramsay Street. It forms the main setting for the late lamented Neighbours. NED PENDLETON now. Which 15th century Inca citadel located in the eastern Cordillera of southern Peru was designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1983?
Machu Picchu
is right, yes. As well as having been a Green member of the European Parliament in the early 21st century, the Italian Reinhold Messner is best known for what activity?
Mountain climbing.
Yes. And he's also a kind of explorer or adventurer. He also made solo crossings of Antarctica, Greenland, and the Gobi Desert. In 2018, the award-winning director and playwright Kwame Kwe Arma succeeded David Lann as the artistic director of which theatre in South London?
The Old Vic?
No. GAIL TRIMBLE?
The National Theatre?
No. ALISON JAY?
The Young Vic?
The Young Vic, yes. Right answer. GAIL TRIMBLE now. What's the more informal name by which nitrous oxide is known?
Laughing gas.
It is. In Japanese culture, what is a katana?
A knife?
No. Anybody know? NED PENDLETON.
A sword.
It's a traditional Japanese sword, yes, single-edged and slightly curving towards the tip, so quite a lot bigger than a knife, and the end of the first round. Roger Bowen yet to score, GAIL TRIMBLE 1, ALISON JAY and NED PENDLETON 3 each. Okay, Roger Bowen, time for the first question today with music attached. And we're dipping into the BBC archives again with a memorable edition of Radio 2's Friday Night is Music Night. It dates from 2004, and the special guest was Andrea Bocelli. Here the tenor concludes a romantic aria, but can you identify the opera it comes from?
Tosca?
Right. Tosca is right, yes. E luceran le stelle, and the stars were shining. It's from the third act of Puccini's opera from 1900, sung by Cavaradossi while he waits for his execution on the roof of the Castel Sant'Angelo. People wishing to work with or care for children in the UK undergo a DBS check. What do the letters DBS stand for?
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Now, does anyone? Nobody's offering, no. Disclosure and barring service. Didn't know that myself, but that's what it is. Alison Jay, according to the Book of Genesis, where did Cain settle when he left Eden?
In the land of Nod.
You may laugh, but it's the right answer.
Well done.
The quote is, in the land of Nod, on the east of Eden. So, well done. In October 2021, a former employee named Francis Haugen told the US Congress that products made by which company harm children, stoke division, and weaken our democracy?
Amazon?
No. Gail Trimble?
Meta, Facebook?
Facebook is the right answer, yes. As we go to Ned Pendleton, the action of which novel by Ian McEwan, first published in 2001, takes place across three time periods: England in 1935, the Second World War, and London in 1999.
Atonement.
Atonement is right, yes. Often a feature of medieval castles, what is an oubliette?
It's like a dungeon chamber where people are put, yeah.
That's right. It's from the French for to forget, literally somewhere you shove a person away and forget about them. Which British physiologist, who with Patrick Steptoe pioneered the use of IVF, infertility treatment, was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 2010?
Winston?
No. No answers? No. His name was Edwards, Sir Robert Edwards. And Gail Trimble's turn come round. In which James Bond film did Daniel Craig make his debut as Bond?
Casino Royale.
Yes. Which political party was led by Angela Merkel during the 16 years she served as German Chancellor?
The Christian Democrats.
That's right, Christian Democrat Union, CDU. Inaugurated in 1943, the Dickin Medal is named after the founder of which British charity that was launched in a cellar in Whitechapel in 1917?
RSPCA?
No. Ned Pendleton?
RSPB?
Nope. Yes, Alison Jay?
The Dogs Trust?
No. And Roger Bowen?
K-9 Defence League?
No. You're all in the right area, but you haven't got the right organisation. The PDSA, the People's Dispensary for Sick Animals. PDSA Dickin Medal is named after the charity's founder, Maria Dickin. It's the highest award an animal can receive whilst serving in military conflict. End of another round. Everyone scored. Roger Bowen, 1. Alison Jay and Gail Trimble, 4 apiece. Ned Pendleton, 5. Still very close as we return to you, Roger Bowen. How do I love thee? Let me count the ways are the opening lines of a sonnet by which 19th century poet?
19th century.
Keats? No. Ned Pendleton?
Tennyson?
No. Gail Trimble.
Elizabeth Barrett Browning.
Is the right answer, yes. Well done. Well done. ALISON JAY, some music for you now. In May 2022, we said goodbye to the actor Dennis Waterman, who, thanks to the BBC's Little Britain, is fondly remembered for singing the theme tunes to series he appeared in. This song, I Could Be So Good For You, from Minder, was his biggest hit. But when we've heard it, I'd like you to name any other series to which Waterman sang the theme song.
I'd be so good for you.
Old Tricks?
No. Ned Pendleton?
Porridge?
No. Gail Trimble?
Only Fools and Horses?
No. Yes, Roger Bowen.
New Tricks?
New Tricks, yes. It wasn't the Old Tricks, I'm afraid. It was New Tricks, well done. Stay Lucky and On the Up were the other two you could have had. Ned Pendleton, in the Barclays FA Women's Super League, which football team successfully defended their title to be crowned champions in May 2022?
Chelsea.
I would expect you to get that, yes. In which regular polygon does each interior angle measure 108 degrees?
Pentagon?
Pentagon's right, yes. The five interior angles of a pentagon add up to 540, so 108 degrees each. The main ingredients of a pina colada cocktail are rum, coconut, and the juice of which fruit?
Pineapple.
Yes. The many pseudonyms used by which film comedian included Charles Bogle, Mahatma Kane Jeeves, and J. Pinkerton Snoopington?
W.C. Fields?
Yes, W.C. Fields is right. The domestic breed of cat known as the Korat, K-O-R-A-T, is named after a province in which country?
Turkey?
Not Turkey, no. Gail Trimble?
Iran?
Nope. Worth a guess. ALISON JAY?
Mexico?
Nope. Roger Bowen?
Iraq?
No, it's Thailand, I'm afraid. Gail Trimble, your question. With the Latin name Anagallis arvensis, which wild flower with a purplish base shares its name with the first in a historical novel sequence by Baroness Orczy, written in the early 20th century?
The Scarlet Pimpernel.
Is right. In Samuel Pepys's diary entry for Monday, September 29th, 1662, which of Shakespeare's plays, whose minor characters include Starveling, Philostrate, and Aegeus, did he describe as the most insipid, ridiculous play that I ever saw in my life?
Midsummer Night's Dream.
Yes, he was, however, cheered up, in his own words, by some good dancing and some handsome women. I played Starveling myself once and did a bit of maypole dancing in that play. Not that Mr. Pepys would have been much impressed by that. What is the name of the flat ring of icy small bodies that revolve around the sun beyond the orbit of the planet Neptune, containing Eris, Pluto, Makemake, and Haumea?
Dwarf planets?
No. Ned Pendleton.
Kuiper Belt.
Yes. Or if you must, the Edgeworth hyphen Kuiper Belt. The Kuiper Belt's the important part. End of another round. And here are the scores. In points, Roger Bowen, 2. ALISON JAY, 4. Gail Trimble, 7. Ned Pendleton, 10. Still anyone's game. And we've reached the point in the contest where we can give our brains a few minutes to sit back and suspend their rivalry. We'll get back to it soon enough. But first, let's have some fun with some questions devised by our Brain of Britain listener in the feature we call Beat the Brains. In a minute, I'll tell you how you can get question ideas to us if you'd like a go at this in future. This doesn't affect the scores at all, but our contenders are going to pool their knowledge to see if they can deal with a pair of questions sent to us by Eddie Duggan in Ipswich. If Eddie's questions defeat the brains, he'll win himself a book voucher prize. Eddie's ideas have a linking theme, which I hope will resonate with at least some of you. Here's question one. Lou Reed's famous song, Walk on the Wild Side, introduces us to a series of colourful characters from Andy Warhol's coterie in New York City in the 1960s. We are told, Holly came from Miami, FLA. Little Joe never once gave it away. Candy came from out on the island. Jackie is just speeding away. What were the full names of those characters? Holly, Joe, Candy, and Jackie.
Oh. I don't even Jackie know if they're
fictional. Are these real people or fictional? Yeah, Jackie Kennedy, I thought.
Could be.
Are they fictional or no?
No.
Well, no, exactly. Holly. So it doesn't help.
Buddy Holly.
Holly Golightly.
Holly.
Buddy Holly.
Holly Golightly.
Yeah. No. Candy.
Candy Staten.
What was the other one?
Joe. Could be
DiMaggio.
Yeah,
well, that's possible.
Really good.
Yeah.
what have we got? Joe DiMaggio, Jackie Kennedy.
Buddy, no, he died, didn't he? Wow.
Well, and it was definitely these were first names.
No.
Oh, I've got to remember what they are again now. Buddy Holly, Candy Staten, Joe DiMaggio, and Jackie Kennedy Onassis.
Goodness me, that's a very eclectic bunch.
All wrong.
And very, very picturesque too, but it's not the right answer.
Surprise.
Now, these are all real people known to Andy Warhol in his actual coterie in New York City. Slightly weird people, it must be said. Oh, strange costumes and antics they got up to. They were Holly Woodlawn, Joe D'Alessandro, Candy Darling, and Jackie Curtis.
Right.
Candy died fairly soon, 74, Jackie in 1985, Holly 2015, and Joe, the last I heard, was managing a residential hostel in LA. Eddie's second question is very much connected, you'll be sorry to hear. Three of these Warhol superstars, because that's what they briefly were, Joe D'Alessandro, Candy Darling, and Jackie Curtis, appeared together in a film produced by Warhol and directed by Paul Morrissey. What was the title of the film?
He did one called Four Stars, I know that, but do you know any others?
Yeah, I haven't got anything else.
No, I've got a clue.
Can anyone name
as good a guess as any, yeah.
Absolutely, yeah, no.
Four Stars?
Nope, it was Flesh.
Oh,
does that ring a bell?
No.
It was first shown in 1968 and was banned for a time in Britain. It was nobody's idea of a commercial success, but it's becoming something of a cult success since, not surprisingly, perhaps. So, thanks for that bit of counterculture nostalgia, Eddie, and well done on beating the brains pretty soundly. You found really a hole in their collective knowledge. So we'll be getting a prize to you very shortly indeed. And from our radio theatre audience here, we offer you something that's very much on the wild side, a radio theatre round of applause. If you'd like to suggest questions to try out on the brains in a future programme, you can email them at any time to brainofbritain@bbc.co.uk. They don't need to be thematically linked. You can make them entirely random. But do make them as interesting as you can so our competitors have something to chew on and discuss. We can't always acknowledge every suggestion we get, but we'll do our best to let you know if we pick them for inclusion in a future programme. Relaxation over, fingers or thumbs back on buttons, please. Tension mounts as we resume the contest and the next round starts with you again, Roger Bowen. Who was the last king of Italy?
Victor Emmanuel.
No. Ned Pendleton.
Umberto II.
Umberto II. Umberto Nicola Tommaso Giovanni Maria di Savoia. Long name, but he reigned for just 34 days. In 1946. Alison Jay, At the 2020 Olympics, held of course in 2021, which American gymnast was forced to withdraw from two events after suffering the innocent sounding but potentially dangerous phenomenon she described as the twisties?
Is that Simone Biles?
It was Simone Biles. These twisties are when an athlete loses all sense of spatial awareness and direction whilst in midair. So no fun to have. Believed for many centuries to be the westernmost point of the known world, which island in the Atlantic Ocean has the nickname the Meridian Island?
Lanzarote?
No. Yes, Gail Trimble.
St. Helena?
No. Ned Pendleton?
Bermuda?
No. Roger Bowen?
Ascension Island?
No, nice selection of islands, but El Hierro is the answer. El Hierro, the furthest west of the Canary Islands. Ned Pendleton, there's music with your next question, and it's Amy Winehouse singing You Know I'm No Good from her 2007 album, which was one of the bestsellers of the noughties. When you've heard it, I'd simply like you to name that album.
I cheated myself.
Back to Black.
Back to Black was the name of the album, yes. The pendulous flowers of the laburnum tree, native to the Alps, but often planted in British gardens, are typically what colour?
Yellow.
Yes. Which Indian writer who died in 2001 is best known for gently comic stories set in a fictional town named Malgudi?
Seth. Bikram Seth.
No. Roger Bowen?
Ghosh?
No. Nobody knows, I think. R.K. Narayan. Gail Trimble, in ancient history, which war was fought in the 5th century BC between Athens and Sparta?
The Peloponnesian War.
It was one of the most significant events in classical Greek history, ending the dominance of Athens and reshaping the ancient world. In 2019, Billy Porter made history when he became the first openly gay black man to win an Emmy for Best Actor. Can you tell me the name of the drama series for which he won this award? Out of time, I'm afraid. Ned Pendleton?
Stranger Things.
No. No more offers. It was called Pose. P-O-S-E. Porter played the character Pray Tell. Scores at the end of another round here. Roger Bowen, 2. Alison Jay, 5. Gail Trimble, 8. Ned Pendleton, now 13. And, folks, I'm sorry to have to tell you, this is the final round of the contest. Returning to Roger Bowen. Which British comedian was the Asian provocateur in the title of a 2015 BBC travel documentary series?
Sanjeev Bhaskar?
No, it wasn't. Ned Pendleton?
Ramesh Ranganathan.
Ramesh Ranganathan is right. He travelled to Sri Lanka to learn about his roots. Alison Jay, in 2016, against Sri Lanka in the second test, which British cricketer became the youngest ever batsman in test history to reach 10,000 runs?
Alistair Cook.
It was. He broke Sachin Tendulkar's record by achieving the feat aged 31 years and 7 months. The first three chapters of which classic children's novel set in Canada are Mrs. Rachel Lynde is surprised, Matthew Cuthbert is surprised, and Marilla Cuthbert is surprised.
Anne of Green Gables?
Yes, the surprise is that instead of the orphan boy the Cuthberts had requested to adopt, they got a girl instead, who was Anne Shirley. In the much-hyped Battle of the Britpop Bands in August 1995, the British rock groups Blur and Oasis vied for the number one position in the charts with songs released on the same day. I'd like you to tell me the titles of both those songs.
Ooh. Park Life and Wonderwall?
No, sorry, it wasn't. Ned Pendleton.
Roll With It and Country House, yeah.
Yes, Country House of Blur and Roll With It of Oasis. It turned out Blur made it number one and Oasis had to settle for number two. Ned Pendleton, your go. Can you tell me who composed the piece of music with the title As Slow As Possible that began on September the 5th, 2001 in a church in Halberstadt, Germany, and which is scheduled to finish 639 years later in 2640?
Cage?
It's got to be John Cage, hasn't it? Yes. Which of the Beatles' number one songs gives its title to the epic 2021 film project by director Peter Jackson, incorporating intimate footage of the group preparing songs for their final album?
Get Back.
Get Back is right, yes. What, according to the Elizabethan dramatist Thomas Dekker, is the golden chain that ties health and our bodies together?
Food?
No. Nope. Gail Trimble?
The soul?
No. Roger Bowen?
Love?
No. Sleep?
Oh, right.
Yes. Gail Trimble, some music for you. And here's the Kyrie Eleison from a Mass by Beethoven, which I'd simply like you to name.
Mrs. Solemnis?
Yes, the great Mrs. Solemnis was first performed in St. Petersburg in 1824. The Austrian actor Christoph Waltz has won two Best Supporting Actor Academy Awards, both for roles in films directed by Quentin Tarantino. Can you name either of those two films?
Pulp Fiction?
No. Ned Pendleton?
Inglourious Basterds.
Was one of them, and the other was Django Unchained. Which brings us to the end of the contest with the following scores. Roger Bowen, 2 points. Alison Jay, 7. Gail Trimble, 9. Ned Pendleton, 18. Ooh, yeah. So very well done indeed, Ned Pendleton. Always slightly ahead and then in the end, emphatically so. We'll be seeing you again in a few weeks. Allow me to thank the other three of you for a most intriguing and well-fought heat. And I'm sorry about the beat the brains. It was just not your territory. We'll be back in Salford next week with another 4 Brain of Britain contenders. I hope you'll be able to join us and thank you for listening today. Goodbye.